It was a very emotional day in that courtroom Tuesday with some key turning points for the defense. We want to warn you, though, some of the images you're about to see are disturbing.
It was too much for Tracy Martin and Sabrina Fulton. The parents of Trayvon Martin had to leave the courtroom, leaving jurors and the public to see this. The lifeless body of their 17-year-old son. Some images too graphic for TV. They were shown during the testimony from Sergeant Anthony Raimondo, the second Sanford police officer to arrive at the scene, who tried to perform CPR.
And were you able to get a pulse?
No, sir, I was not.
The state also called on police crime scene technician Diane Smith. Jurors saw the evidence she collected, like George Zimmerman's handgun, clothing, Skittles, and the fruit drink Martin was carrying. Smith told prosecutors she couldn't find any blood on the sidewalk where Zimmerman said the teen slammed his head, but during cross-examination, her answer left room for the defense.
When you were walking down the sidewalk with the flashlight, the idea was to see if there was obvious blood?
Yes.
And it was raining?
That is correct.
In fact, the defense was able to turn the table on several of the state's witnesses, like Wendy Dorival, who trained Zimmerman about neighborhood watch guidelines.
He seemed like he really wanted to make changes in his community to make it better.
Celine Bahadur told prosecutors she heard what sounded like running from left to right outside her unit the night of the shooting, a detail the defense challenged her on, as it was the first time she offered that version of events publicly on the record. Mark O'Meara further attacked Bahadur's credibility by showcasing her online behavior.
Tell me what that says on your Facebook front page right there. Just read that.
Prosecute the killer of our son, 17-year-old Trayvon Martin. Sign the petition.